So these people are so big, these people are so good, these people are so up there. How do I relate with them? But outside, I'm acting like you should be grateful that I am giving you audience to talk to me. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is your go-to glow up channel. It's for everything glow. We talk about everything from physical glow to inner glow to just overall glow. If you're not a part of the family yet, make sure to subscribe. And by the end of this video, you're going to be able to style your ponytail like a pro. And the next time you're stepping out, your confidence level is going to be on 100. Now, this is also a get ready with me video because today I'm going to go check out schools for my son. And so, get ready with me. Now it's time for the girl chat, guys. There are a lot of times that so many things you want to do and the doubts start to set in. You start to feel like you're not good enough, or there are people that are better than you at this. There are people that won't like what you do, or they will criticize you, they will say you're not good enough. And if you check it, the root of those doubts is really a lack of confidence. I know a lot of people suffer from a lack of confidence, and I think it's pretty normal. I used to suffer from a serious lack of confidence until I started to realize that there's room for me. There's room for me everywhere. It's just left for me to decide whether or not I want to take up that room. The thing is, I truly believe that God has created all of us the same. I mean, we're all equal in God's eyes. So that means that everybody has equal share of this earth. So there's no room that you're not allowed into if you want to go in. I don't mean like the places where they put restricted stuff on. I mean like you can occupy as much space as you want, as long as it does not affect the next person or is not harmful to the next human. Everybody has equal space on this earth, and the people that seem to be taking up more space than others are just people who are more confident than others. In my video, 5 things I wish I knew at 20, one of the things I realized is if you don't ask, you won't get. So that is a result of confidence too, because you have to be confident enough to ask. And if you stay till the end of this video, you can make yourself go from a place of low confidence to a place of higher confidence. First of all, you have to remember that you are one of a kind. Literally one of a kind, because you know how fingerprinting works. Everybody has a unique set of fingerprints. That means that it is only you that can be you. I mean, there's space for just one person on this set of fingerprints, and it is you. So the fact that somebody somewhere, the fact that God saw you as important enough to give you your own unique set of fingerprints means that you are unique. It means that there's only one of you. Nobody can make the kind of imprint you can make. I think that is important for you to note, because when you step out of the house, you see a lot of people. You see a lot of people doing a lot of different things. Some people are winning, some people are, you know, steady shining, and it just looks like they were born to shine. I don't think anybody was born not to shine. I think we all have a sparkle, we all have whatever it takes to shine in us. And nobody can shine like you can. The first step is for you to realize that you are you, a very special, very unique creation that nobody can be. Your next step towards confidence is to find your strength and play it up. Focus on what you're good at. And if I'm good at cooking, then as opposed to going to struggle to right, I will focus on how to get better at cooking, because that is where I shine. That is where that is what I'm good at. So what you will need to do is to figure out your strengths and your weaknesses. Everybody has weaknesses. There is nobody on this earth that knows how to do everything so spectacularly. Here's the thing, even if you cannot find what you're naturally good at, there has to be something that you love to do. Passion is a great place to start. Passion itself is a strength. There are lots of people that do not know their passion. So you just find what you love to do or what you're naturally good at and you start from there. Play upon your strengths. There are so many things you can do. There are so many things that come naturally to you. If you focus on them, the weaknesses will take a back seat. There's no need to focus on your weaknesses. All of us have them. Everybody you see shining out there, there's one thing or the other that they cannot do. So when you figure out your strengths, then you just go up from there. If your strength is cooking, watch cooking shows, read about cooking, find new recipes, develop new recipes. Confidence you get from being good at something is on a different level. Your next step towards confidence is to get educated. Guys, I don't mean like go to school. I mean get educated on the topic that interests you, on your strengths. Now we've found out that we should get and develop our strengths. Listen, there is a confidence that comes with knowledge. There's this assurance that you know something, okay? I don't mean be cocky or be arrogant about it. I just mean I'm walking into a room and, you know, I know that I know my stuff. I know that if you talk to me about this, I can tell you where it came from, where it started, what happened to it, and where it's headed. This is the confidence that knowledge brings. We have a whole world of resources now at our fingertips. If you're watching this, that means you have internet. Go on Google, find out about stuff. Now, I can tell you a little bit about getting a YouTube channel. I didn't know this a few months back. I could not have a conversation about YouTube a few months back. Of course, apart from the fact that I watch YouTube videos. But now, because I have tried to do my research, I have tried to get better at something that I really am really passionate about and I really want to do, I can have a proper conversation now about YouTube. Even if I'm having a conversation with an OG, somebody who is much bigger than me on YouTube, at least I know the right questions to ask to learn from that person. I'm not saying suddenly you have to know everything about that field. However, if today I can have a conversation with one of the people I admire on YouTube, let's say Dima Omi. If I sat down now, I already know the questions I'm going to ask her. How do you do this? How do you do that? How do you come up with your topics? How do you record? There are so many things to learn, but if you don't know where to even start asking the questions, then it's hard for you to find how to start learning it. So that's what I mean by knowledge. Knowledge is knowing the right questions to ask as much as knowing the answers to those questions. Our next step towards confidence is to not compare yourself with anybody else. You guys are on different journeys. You're on a different journey from myself and from anybody else. Nobody's journey is the same. Nobody can do you like you. So there's no need to compare yourself with anybody else. You're comparing your chapter 5 to somebody's chapter 25. There's no comparison, okay? And here's what I truly believe. Everybody has different phases in their lives. Everybody has different lessons to learn at different times. It's not a race. Just be in your lane. Just try to be better than you were yesterday. Try to be in a better place than you were the last time. You have to ginger yourself. You have to support yourself. You have to hype yourself because nobody else is going to do it for you. So you have to do it for yourself. You have to realize that there are small victories and there are big victories and they are all victories. Guys, don't compare yourself to anybody else. You are you. You are unique. There is nobody else like you and you have to remember that. You have to keep telling yourself that. Let it be a mantra. You wake up in the morning, I am fabulous. I am unique. I am the only one of me there is. I'm going to learn something new today. I'm going to be better than I was yesterday. I'm going to do something new today. I'm going to do something to improve myself today. You cannot sit in one place not doing anything to improve yourself and cry about how you're not good enough. How do you become better than you were before? You have to look for it. You have to search for it. Sorry, there's this movie I watched when I was little. I really loved it. It's called The King and I. There's this lady who has a son. And she came over to an Asian country, Siam, I think, to teach the king's children. And you know, they were quite primitive in Siam at the time. She came from England. And you know, she was quite scared because there were swords and there were scary looking men and you know, all that. and they were still in that age where you were crawling around for the king and you were, you know, the king was an absolute ruler. And you know, there's this song they used to sing. One of the lines is, when I fool the people I fear, I fool myself as well. But the song was not talking about like deceit or anything like that. It was talking about what she does when she's afraid. And that's where lack of confidence comes from. You know, you're afraid that you won't get it right. You're afraid that you'll fail. You're afraid that you won't be good enough. Part of the song is, you know, I whistle a happy tune, and every single time the happiness in the tune convinces me that I'm not afraid. Now, she's not saying she's not afraid. She's just saying, this is what I do when I am afraid. And when I act like I am not afraid, then the people that are looking at me cannot tell whether I'm afraid or not. I'm the only one that knows I'm afraid. You get? If you don't feel it, act like it. Fake it till you make it. When you start to act confident, you will forget at some point that you're acting. People react to the vibe you give. Step into a place and you're acting like, well, the president's daughter. They know you're not the president's daughter, clearly, but for you to be acting so important, you must be somebody's daughter. Of course I'm somebody's daughter. Kate, I'm acting like I've arrived, I belong here. In fact, you should be grateful that you have my presence. Maybe I'm shaking my shoes. Maybe I feel like, okay, so these people are so big. These people are so good. These people are so up there. How do I relate with them? But outside, I'm acting like you should be grateful that I am giving you audience to talk to me. People can tell the vibe you're bringing. If you're bringing the, I don't know whether I should be here. I'm so grateful that you guys are allowing me to be here. I don't feel like I belong. That's one way to come into a room. That's one way to arrive in place. And hi guys, I'm here. Do something to be worth my time. Of course, I'm not saying go talk to people like that, but you understand what I mean. Same person, two different ways to approach a place. And honestly, I have tried it a lot of times. I have seemed and appeared confident when inside I was truly shaking, and it made all the difference. You tell yourself you are the princess of Zamunda and act like it, okay? When you act like it, people will treat you like it. Here's an example. One time I attended this meeting, and the meeting had people that I really admired, and ordinary me, before I started being deliberate about being confident, about looking confident, would have just sat in a meeting, you know, quietly and not contributed anything or said anything, just be in my quiet little corner, and you know, at least I attended the meeting, you know. But because I was deliberately trying to, this thing has to be deliberate, guys. Honestly, there's no magic that will happen. You have to deliberately want it. You have to work towards it. So, you know, and while I was there, things came up. I had things to say. The me before would have just kept quiet. Let them not say that I'm talking too much. Let them not say, this one, where is she coming from? Who is she? What does she know? You know, I spoke up, and it turned out they thought I made sense. And you know, by the end of the meeting, I had people I was looking up to collecting my number, and I'm like, okay, well, this is it. You know, it was so exciting. Fake it till you make it, guys. If you don't feel confident inside, act like it. And if you see a difference, if you try this and you see a difference, please come back and tell me, because I believe this will work. So guys, I had so much fun making this video. This channel is about sharing everything that I'm learning every day, because I've deliberately decided to better myself. I want to be the best version of myself that there can be. And you can do that too. In truth, you have to put in the work, but you also have to know what to do. So if you want to continue on this growth journey with me, please subscribe to my channel. And you can follow me on Instagram, you can follow me on Twitter. I'll see you guys in the next video. Make sure to try out what we talked about. Bye.